Welcome back to the Sonicview Learning Center. Today, we're going to be discussing AutoMixer and how to set it up and how to use it. So first off, what is AutoMixer? AutoMixer has been designed for speech, but the function can be used for backing vocals or grouping of similar instruments, and it's where the Sonicview will compare mic inputs and automatically adjust gain to maintain a specific balance of channels set to our own preferences. This can be especially useful in meetings, panel discussions, and basically any form of speaking engagement. So to use AutoMixer, we're going to need to make sure we've upgraded our console to at least version 2.0 firmware. So before we dive into using the AutoMixer, actually setting it up and a real world scenario, let's take a quick look at the user interface and all the features. So first off, we're going to enter the menu. Next, we're going to go to Mixer Setup and then Automatic Mixer. We pull it up, here's the UI. So from here, the Automatic Mixer module, this is where we can control all of the different parameters for the AutoMixer itself. So towards the top right is the AutoMixer on off button. So if we click on that, you can see we can turn it off or we can push it again and we can turn it on. So in order to use this, obviously we're going to make sure that this is on. Now from left to right, let's take a look at some of the other features here. So we've got our meter input and output. So you can see we can use up to 16 channels here. We've got 1 through 8. We've got 9 through 16. And then the next tab here is the gain and weight tab. Again, 1 through 8, 9 through 16. Next, we have our groups. So these are our AutoMixer groups. So we have 4 that we can use. Those are controlled right here. And then below all of this, we have our actual channels themselves. Below the channel names here, so you can see channels 1 through 8 at the top because I'm on the top 8. Or if we touch the 9 through 16, those also switch to 9 through 16 just there. So for here, we've got our individual channels. We have our group assignment. We have our priority button. And then below that, we can see our gain metering and then our weight metering and also the weight adjustment here from the bottom. So now that we're familiar with the module and all of its basic properties, let's go ahead and set it all up for use in a live situation. As we can see, the interface is straightforward. It's very easy to use, which is nice because that means we're not going to have to do a bunch of menu diving to make adjustments on the fly. Also, for easy access, I've gone ahead and set up a user key, which is something that maybe you would want to do in the future. So I have user key D set up to just go ahead and bring up the Automatic Mixer module. That's a super easy function to do. You can go back through our Sonicview Learning Center videos and find the user key assignment video and see how to set that all up. So first things first, as you can see, I've got 2 screens of the Sonicview 24 on your screen here. So I don't have channel 1 through 8 to show you, so I'm going to switch over to channel 9 through 16. On any channel that we're going to be sending here to the Automatic Mixer, we need to make sure that we have the proper gain staging going on. So if you look over here, I've got channel 9, adjusted some gain there. Channel 10, I've adjusted gain there. And then I've skipped over 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And I have set up channel 16 here, gain. So we want to make sure the gain staging is appropriate before we send it to the Automatic Mixer. So for any channel we're going to be sending to the Automatic Mixer, we're going to now bring up the fader to unity or 0. Next step is we want to make sure that none of the mutes are on these channels. So if we had, accidentally had a mute on here, we could just go ahead and turn that off. We don't want anything muted going to the AutoMixer. So for the next step, we're going to actually assign these groups, these AutoMix groups. So I've adjusted 9, 10, and 16. So let's turn on our group that we're going to send those to. Group A is where we want these. So group A, and we've got this on group A. Now for 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15, we're not going to send that to the AutoMixer. We didn't adjust the gain, but if we're in a real world scenario, maybe there's other things coming in on these channels, but we don't want them to the AutoMixer. So we're going to select the group here for our, so channel 11, there's 3 dashes, removes it from the group settings on the AutoMixer. So we're going to do that for the same on all of those that we're not sending. So no 11, 12, 13, 14, or 15. So now we've just got 9, 10, and 16 on our group A, which we made sure to have it turned on. And if we assign this to anything like group B, we would just take that, assign it to group B, and make sure that we have our group B turned on. So you can see it's not grayed out, but we're not going to do that for now. So back to A. So if we'd like to have one of these channels in the AutoMixer to have more weight than the other ones, we can do that with the priority function. So for example, you know, say we have a panel discussion and group nine is the moderator and we want their voice to carry a little bit more weight above everybody else. That way they can talk over the group if it gets unruly or just have that voice that guides everybody. So what we do there is we turn on the top priority button on this channel. And now we can give this a little bit of weight by going down here and adjusting the weight parameter. Now there's not an easy one size fits all for you should add this amount of gain or you should subtract this amount of gain, anything like that. Just do it based on your ears, you know, listen to it and see how it flows. So now if we were going to use multiple groups, we could actually give top priority to one of the groups. So like we, you know, we grade these out before, but let's say we adjusted these and these are, you know, within our, you know, auto mix parameters here. So let's change some of these to a different group. So we'll go B on those, we'll go C on these here. Then we'll make sure that our group is on. There we go. So for example, we've got our moderator on A, but maybe we want everybody in A to have, you know, a little bit more weight than B and C together. So we could come up here, top priority, turn top priority on, and now you see top is lit up on all of those. We could switch this if we wanted to say B, and now we see it's been switched over. Group B now has top priority of the groups. So again, this is fairly simple to, you know, use. We also have at the top a low cut and release. So these pop up at the bottom and you can use these encoders to adjust your low cut and your release parameters there as well. So this is a really simple to use interface. You can just dive in quickly and make adjustments on the fly, especially if you're using a user key to set that up. The automatic mixer feature is going to be a game changer for the speaking engagements that you are engineering. So, you know, no more writing faders, no more trying to wrangle multiple speakers at once. It can all be done from this module right here on your screen. So click the link on your screen for more in-depth tutorials on the Sonicview XP series. And as always, be sure to click like and subscribe to be notified when we post new videos.